Ah, yes. I have been waiting for this thing. So I've been using this budget UR UAV backpack for over a year now, and probably a lot longer than that. And a combination of me misusing it and time has definitely taken its toll on it. So I've got a hole here where the zip is broken and my drinks bottle is coming out. And there's all sorts of holes in this pocket in the side here. I've actually lost a couple of cables out of here because of that. But there are some problems with it in general that I have found. For example, where this quadcopter is on here, if I just unclip that. So I actually lost the clip here and a quadcopter fell off. And it's because of these clips here. They are very loose. So that's a problem that you can see there. Look, I can just pull that and this is just coming off. There you go. Look, that's a problem with it right there. And I've just filled it full of stuff in general. Like I've misused it on the side here. So I think this is for like holding your chair or something. But I always put a quad in there. And the back is absolutely filled with props. So let's see what this new version is like. So this is the new UR UAV backpack. And it looks very different to the one that I already have. And if you don't have an FPV backpack, then they are extremely useful if you are out all of the time, like I am. But if you go for a known brand one, they can be over £100, and I just can't justify that price. So these ones here are budget bags, and that one has definitely paid the price. The thing is, though, my friend Phil has this one, and he hasn't misused it, and his just looks perfect. So I think I'm definitely the cause of some of the problems this one has got. But looking at this new one here, seems they've changed a lot. Straight away, I can see on the front here, we've got some carbon fiber parts, and this is a UR UAV like battery strap for putting your quads on. So that's not going to come apart. Then if I look underneath, we've got some grips there, which the original one hasn't got. And on the side, we've got proper pockets rather than the sort of netting. So that's completely different as well. What I am seeing is some extra clips here, but these are the same type of clips as the original. So you can put a quad there, and potentially two on the side here. My only concern is, yeah, look at that. As soon as I picked it up, this is coming apart here. So that's unfortunate straight away for carrying more quads. There's some padding on the back there, and these straps look nice and strong. Let's take a look inside the first zip. So already we have got these like pulls on the zips, which is nice. And that's the first pocket there. Look at that. These look like, yeah, things for tools. That is good, because that's a problem I have with that one, is there aren't any like pockets for individual tools. And there's loads more pockets here. Look at that, two in there. And oh yes, one here as well. Let's open this up. Something in there, is there? Nah, it's just the thing showing through there from the other side. Yeah, loads more pockets in this one, which is good. So that's the front pocket. There's another pocket in here as well for stuff. Yeah, definitely a problem with that one. You've only got sort of like the pocket on the side is like a pocket in the middle, but other than that, you've just got space there. So this one's definitely winning when it comes to pockets. And there is another zip here. So is this gonna be sort of like the main bit of space? Yeah, it looks like it. Oh, wow. Loads of pockets there, sort of like this plastic here. Yeah, feels more rigid. Not sure how long that's going to last, but we will see. And again, pocket there, pocket there. And this looks like the waterproofing, which goes over the top. Yeah, and then we've got a couple of these boards, but actually not as many as the other one. So yeah, smaller boards there, but maybe like a bigger space or an easier use of space, because we've got this on here, and I think that's gonna make a big difference. It's gonna stop everything falling forward. So that's better for sure. It's a problem with that one. Everything sort of just falls forward. And then I've got a back pocket here the same. And that's just the same as the other one there. So you can just stick random stuff in there. So it's looking good apart from these here, which is a bit of a shame, but this one is absolutely spent. So I've got no other option than to use this guy. Now we're in lockdown at the moment, so I'm not going anywhere anyway, but I know how useful these things are. So I can test over time whether it's gonna last like I did that one. Okay, so I have transferred all of my stuff over, and there is definitely a better use of space with this, but it's also made me realize how much stuff was in my original bag that I don't need. Look at all that lot. No wonder it was falling apart. Far too many props than I need in there. I really like this front compartment. So one of the problems with this bag is stuff falling out of it when you open it up, and they've sorted that out with this one, because we've got this front compartment here which can be opened when the bag is upright, and this has got all kinds of stuff in here for the tools, which I really like. These ones down here are a little bit small for my tools. I guess mini screwdrivers and stuff would be good in there, but I got all sorts of stuff in these pockets now, and this sits pretty flat. The problem I had with this one is because there's no pockets, it sort of all bulges out, but you can kind of flatten it down here, and there's even this little pocket with stuff in here as well, so that's pretty flat. Also, this pocket up here is brilliant. Actually has this bag here, and it comes down so you can put a lot in there as well, and it keeps the profile nice and flat. So when you zip this one back up, you can then lie the bag on its back and undo this. Now, I haven't used any of these pockets here because they kind of would have all the stuff falling out if you have it like that, but that's fine. It gets too bulky anyways if you put these in, so I guess they could have done away with those pockets, but extra pockets are always good. And this is just superb. This thing here just stops everything falling out. On this one, you sort of had straps going across, but didn't do the job at all. So undo this now. I do think there's less space in this bag, either that or it's made better use of this space. But I've copied my friend Phil here and used two of these boards, and that sort of thickens it up. I've got my DJI transmitter here, and I've got my lipos here, and then my goggles here. Not really much room for anything else. In this bag, I could kind of stuff my Fat Shark goggles in there and somehow another transmitter at the same time, but maybe that's why it's all falling apart. I definitely use this part of the bag way too much. Look at all that rubbish in there as well that I don't need. So when you have filled this main compartment up, you can't really fit much in these pockets in the side because they don't open up that much. So I've just got my pegs here for my landing mat, and also stops my chair from flying away in the wind as well. But yeah, it can't really put that much in there. I'm sure I will rejig all of this because I did with that one, but this is just how I'm feeling about it at the moment. I think this will be good for like sticking SD cards in there as well. What I do like is that there aren't really any pockets where stuff can get lost, so that's a bonus for me. And the back compartment here, because it's flat and I don't want it to get bulky, I've just put a couple of props in there, quite a lot of props. There's the Nazgul props and the Johnny FPV props, but I had all of those in the last one, so I have to make sure that I don't put too much stuff in, because I think that's basically what's bust the zip on it. So I thought I'd give a close-up of this bracket here because it looks good. We've got two screws there and what looks like a carbon fiber plate, but it's not, because you can't see the layers of carbon fiber there. So maybe glass fiber or something like that. I don't know really. But if we compare that to this one over here, this one has stayed intact. And this is just leather here. You can see, though, that there is a little bit of slack on it from the weight of the quadcopters. But then again, this thing here could completely snap off, I guess. So that's something I'll just have to update over time. Got one quadcopter on here, which fits fine. But I'm not going to be able to use these because look at that. it just comes apart. But I've realized that there's nothing stopping me just sticking another long battery strap through there, and then I don't have to use these. I can use another battery strap. I don't know whether that'll rip this off eventually, but it's going to be the weight of a quadcopter on there anyways. And actually, I could have done that with this bottom one, realizing that. I never even thought to use a battery strap, but yeah, it seems to work fine. Something that does happen with this one, and it's the same with the old one really, is that if you've got a 5-inch quad on the front there, you can't really fit anything underneath, which is why I didn't really bother with that one over there. You could end up crushing your quad unless you always sit the bag on its back like that. So I think I'm gonna leave that for now and just have this quad here and then utilize these at the side with another battery strap. You are given this waterproof bag to put over the top of the backpack, but you got one of these with the first version and I haven't used it at all, so it just takes up space in the bag, so I'm not going to be using it. So this is the new one against the old one, and as you can see, it is a smaller bag than the older one. I have managed to fit all of the stuff that I use out of this one in there, but I think I could fit an extra transmitter in that one, even though it was sort of bulging and really didn't fit. It would go in there, whereas this one, I don't think it will. So bear that in mind, it is a smaller bag. And just comparing the two here as well, you can see the more sort of intricate strap here on the back compared to this one, which is fairly simple. Another thing I like is there is sort of like a piece of card or something in there that makes it more easier to pick up from there. This one here tears all of the time. I can hear it tear when I lift it up, so that's also an improvement as well. So there you go, that is my look at the new URUAV FPV backpack. I'll put a link in the video description as well as a pinned comment if you wish to check it out. I do think they have made better use of the space than the first one, and the pockets are really, really welcome. But, you know, this is a budget bag, and as you can see, after over a year, this one has gotten really worn. So I guess I'll report, maybe in a year's time, what the state of this one is. So as always, thanks so much for watching. Please continue to subscribe. Cheers.